One morning, Bill and Ben couldn't wait to start playing the new game they'd invented the day before. They called their game Pebble Rolling, but the pebbles wouldn't roll where Bill and Ben wanted them to roll.
What a shock. Are there any more flying pebbles? Oh, what is the world coming to? I just can't believe this. I'm moving all my nuts to a new store. My old stores are in such secret places, I keep forgetting where they are. Squirrels are funny like that.
In the garden next door, Rose was watching the children who lived in her house play on the lawn.
Such charming, polite children. I hope you two will grow up to be charming and polite.
Yes, Rose.
Oh, all right. Flop. Floop. Flee.
At first, Bill thought the strange round thing might be Boo, the hedgehog.
Hop-a-lug-a-boo!
Ooh.
But Ben found there were no prickles on the strange round thing.
Hello, Bill. Hello, Ben. No, I'm not a strange round thing. I'm me. I'm... Oh, wait a minute. Don't tell me. I'm Boo. That's who I am. I'm not a strange round thing.
Bill and Ben had decided to ask Slowcoach about the strange round thing.
Oh, rubber-dubber-dee, Slowalo.
Oh, yes, I know a lot about things, especially strange round things. Come in.
Oh, this looks tasty. A sweet, juicy apple. Oh, I must eat more fruit.
Your strange round thing sounds to me like a sweet, juicy apple. Now, I shall now read to you all about apples. Oh, but I can't think where I've put my glasses.
What could Bill and Ben do? The strange round thing had vanished.
Last one's there and there and there and there. The shed. I shan't forget the shed. My nuts are in the shed. Got it? My nuts are in the shed. My nuts are in the shed. My nuts are in the shed.
Rubber flobberding?
No. I haven't seen a strange round thing.
Oh.
You could ask Whoops. He often sees strange things.
Oh, rubber-dubber-deed!
A sweet, juicy apple? No, I've not seen a sweet, juicy apple. If I'd seen a sweet, juicy apple, I'd have turned it straight into food for plants. That's my job, you know. Good morning.
Oh,
Flub!
Hey, Flub and up an apple!
Oh, Flub and up!
Oh, thank you, Bill. Oh, thank you, Ben. I've had that thing stuck on my beak all morning.
Flubba-dubba-dweedle-apple?
No, it's not a sweet, juicy apple. It tasted horrid. I don't know what it'll do next.
What?
Oh!
What's that with you, look?
Oh, Dad, it's you. Careful, that round thing's dangerous.
No, it's not, it's a toy. The children in our garden, they've got lots of those round things. They play with them. They throw them about, kick them, like this. Hey. Ooh.
Ooh.
It won't hurt you.
Go flop.
Bill had a great idea. The kicking game was much more fun than pebble rolling.
So that's your strange round thing. What did you do to it?
Kick.
You must have kicked it very hard, Ben.
Flop.
Ben showed Weed just how hard he had kicked the round thing.
Yeah, what a good morning's work.
Don't just stand there. Pull it out. Oh dear. Excuse me. Is anyone there? Oh, please, excuse me, I see. Oh, thank you. If it does belong next door, send it straight back. It's nothing but trouble. Is this your doing? That, Ben, is a ball. It belongs to the children who play in my garden. Kindly leave it here and return to your own garden. I hope that will teach you two not to meddle with things you don't understand.
Yes, Rose. Oh, all right.
Bill and Ben were glad to play their pebble rolling game again.
Oh, excuse me, Bill, Ben. I'm feeling a bit, peckish. Can you remember where I put my new store of nuts?
Half lobbed up a dead.
The shed, of course. Oh, silly me. The shed. You'd think I'd remember the shed. Oh, my mind must be playing tricks on me. I don't know what's come over me.
Bill and Ben remembered the kicking game, and they decided that pebble rolling was much, much safer.
Now they'll be sleeping in their pots all night long. Bill and Ben, the flower pot men.
Mm-hmm.
Bill and Ben. Bill and Ben.
It was a beautiful morning in the garden, but Slowcoach hadn't noticed. He seemed to be very cross about something.
Oh, botheration. Where did I put the wretched things? I had them last night. Oh, yes. Oh, bother. Oh, who put that there? Oh, I did. Bish, bother, and buckets of beetles. Where are they?
Goody. Oi, hey, Flubberlub.
Flubberlub.
Oh, indeed, I hear the flubber. What's Flubber Slubberlub? Flubber Slubberlubberlub.
No, Bill, I don't know what the matter with slow coaches.
Flubberlubber, oh, mother, oh, mother, oh, miss mother.
Yes, I know he sounds upset, Ben. Perhaps you should go and ask him what's bothering him.
Oh, Flubber.
Hey, oh. What's happening? Is that you two troublemakers?
Bill and Ben said they didn't want anything. They were just wondering what Slowcoach was fretting about.
I'll tell you what's wrong. I was reading a very interesting book last night. Oh, very interesting. And I must have nodded off for a moment or two. Because the next thing I know, there they are. Not there. Flub? Not who? What? My spectacles. Someone has pinched my spectacles and I can't see a thing without them.
Ooh.
Oh, ouch.
Oh, Slowcoach, are you all right?
It wasn't you two, was it? One of your pranks? Flub? A likely story.
I don't think it can have been Bill and Ben, Slowcoach. They were asleep all last night.
Bill said that he and Ben would find the spectacle snaffler.
Yeah. I'll believe it when I see it. And don't make too much noise about it. I'm off home.
Bill said that as the spectacles were stolen during the night, it was quite likely the thief would wait until darkness before he tried to take anything else. And when he came, Bill and Ben would be waiting.
Ooh. Ooh, Flubberlub.
Flubber Dan. Flubber Dan. Flubber Dan.
Bill reminded Ben about their plan to find the mysterious spectacle thief.
Oh, Flubberdide!
By now, Bill and Ben were beginning to wonder whether this had been such a good idea after all. But having come this far, they weren't going to give up.
Flubberdat! Flubberdizzle. Flubberdizzle!
The flower pot men thought they might, at last, have found the thief. Bravely, they made their way towards the kennel.
Lovely sluggy sandwich.
Oh, he flubberdoo!
Flubber-flee! What's happening? It's the middle of the night. What are you up to, waking folk up? And
Flubber lobber slobber splacker lobber lobber dob.
Looking for the person who stole Slowcoach's spectacles?
Flub?
Well, I hope you don't think I... Well, you can think again. Now, if you don't mind, I've got some sleep to catch up on.
Flubber that?
Ben didn't want to find out what was making the noise.
Flubber lobber doing all!
But Bill said they had a job to do, and Ben agreed. Bill was determined they were going to see their job through to the end.
Flop it up!
Oh, it's cold. Cold.
Flop it up and at you.
I'm a fool. Oh, thank goodness someone's come at last. The man left the greenhouse door open last night and I'm freezing. You couldn't close it, could you? But what are you two doing here? It's way past your bedtime.
What? Probably in a funny ride.
Don't flog.
Flogging a flob of leaf.
Looking for a thief?
Flop.
So what's he stolen then, this thief?
Slubber double X.
Slow coach's spectacles. Well, well, well.
Bill and Ben thought it sounded as if the thief had come back. And that Slowcoach was struggling with him inside his house. The thief hadn't been in Slowcoach's house at all. The noise was all being made by Slowcoach, who, though he was asleep, was having rather a restless night.
Oh, yeah. The young people of today. Oh, no. No respect.
Bill suggested that the thief might still come. So the flowerpot men decided to stay and watch over Slowcoach's house until he did.
What's this blocking my door? Slobodobodob. What's the big idea, eh? It's a bit early for fun and games, isn't it? Did you catch the scoundrel who pinched my glasses? Flob.
Flobodob.
You fell asleep while on duty, you useless pair. And talking of sleep, what a rotten night I had. Rotten! Felt almost like I'd got something stuck down my shell. Well, would you credit it? In my shell all the time. Well, they must have slipped down there when I wasn't looking. That's most amusing. Oh, yes.
You poor things. All that trouble for nothing.
But Bill and Ben were too tired to answer after their night of adventure. All they wanted to do was sleep.
Bill and Ben, the flower pot men. Bill and Ben, the flower pot men. They've been playing in the garden, playing with their friends. Now they'll be sleeping in their pots all night long. Bill and Ben.
It was a beautiful day in the garden, and Weed was enjoying herself, basking in the warm rays of the sun. Bill and Ben were still asleep. Morning, Weed. Lovely day, if you like that sort of thing.
Good morning, Slowcoat.
Don't tell me those two layabouts haven't got up yet.
Well, they did have a very busy day yesterday, Slow Coach.
Right. Come on, let's be having you. Rise and shine. You can't spend all your lives in bed. It's high time you were up and at them. Hey, flobbidobbidleep. A flobbidobbiday.
You see, Slow Coach, they weren't asleep at all. They've been busy inventing a new game.
Inventing a game? Oh, what's it called? Hunt the snow? Hide and snooze? Tiddly 40 winks? Flob? It's a... Oh, they couldn't invent something particularly stupid that had already been invented by someone stupider than them.
Oh, excuse me. Couldn't help overhearing. If it's games you're after, you can't be in a good game of Count the Pebble.
Oh, flubber-double-head.
How do you play it? Well, simple. You find a nice, interesting pebble and then... And this is the interesting bit. You count it.
Bill and Ben looked for a nice, interesting pebble, and it wasn't long before they found one.
Flubber-dub.
Oh! Flub.
Flub.
Flub?
Flub.
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 Bill and Ben agreed that Count the Pebble was not a very exciting game.
Flubber-dub.
Flubber-dub-a-doring.
You are a silly pair.
Flubberdilly?
Fancy playing a silly game like that. You ought to be playing something that's more fun. Something like, Hunt the Nut.
Flubber-nut?
That's right. Hunt the Nut.
Oh, flubber-dead.
Oh, it's easy. You hunt for nuts. And when you find one, oh, what excitement. Can't stop. I'm playing it myself.
Bill and Ben thought a game of Hunt the Nut would be great fun.
Flub.
They couldn't find a nut anywhere.
You there?
Hello.
What are you two doing, cluttering up my garden?
Flubber-dubber-day-da-dame.
Playing a game?
Flubber-dubber-dubber-fun.
Well, you don't look like you're having much fun.
Flubber-dubber-dame-dose?
Me? Know any games? The very idea. Games are for those who have nothing better to do with their time. Isn't that right, my dears?
Yes.
I'd like to play games.
Bill and Ben decided that they might as well go home.
Ooh! Flub it up!
The stick had given Bill an idea.
Why?
An idea for a game.
flubberwee and gong.
Bill had thrown the stick into their garden, but he wasn't too sure where it had landed. The first person to find it would be the winner and could have the next throw.
What is going on? Stupid twig, where did you come from? What? Thank you, but there's no need to be quite so rough.
As Ben had been first to find the stick, it was his turn to throw it. When they got to the garden next door, their stick had gone.
Flubber-dubber-wig?
No, I have not seen a twig. What would a beautiful creature such as I want with a twig?
Bill suggested that they try again.
Flubber-dubber-drain.
When Bill and Ben got back to the garden next door, they found their stick had disappeared again.
Huh?
It was a mystery. Their twigs kept on disappearing.
Flubber-deer! Flubber-sub-an-answer-wig!
Once again, their twigs had disappeared. They decided to tell Weed all about it.
It can't be easy to play chase the twig when your twigs keep disappearing.
Oh, I've been having better luck next door.
Oh, hello, Pry. How's your new nest coming along?
Well, I was finding loads of twigs in the garden next door. But there don't seem to be so many
now. Flubberwig said door.
Flubber long and a flubberwubber web.
I don't know, Ben. One twig looks much like another to me. But there were lots of them.
Ah! Door! Flubber! You mean it? How do we? And a prank! And a...
What's so funny? Well, I've got better things to do than stand round here with a load of laughing jackdaws. I've got a nest to build.
Oh, flubber-dubber-nest? Oh, flubber-dub!
Help? Yes, of course you can help. I can do with all the help you can give me.
Well, hey.
Oh, thank you, Bill. Just what I needed, Ben. Thank you. Oh, well, thank you both. I've finished my nest. Would you like to see it?
Oh, lovely!
Grab hold, then. Well, what do you think?
Flubbly. Flubber, nice cozy.
Yes, I pride myself on being a particularly expert nester.
Poor Pry. The flower pot men were so comfortable in her new nest, and they'd made themselves so tired helping her, that they'd fallen asleep. But she didn't have the heart to wake them, so she left them to their dreams.
Bill and Ben, the flower pot men. Bill and Ben, the flower pot men. They've been playing in the garden, playing with their friends. Now they'll be sleeping in their pots all night long. Bill and Ben, Bill and Ben. Bill and Ben. The Flower Pot Man. The Flower Pot Bill and Ben. The Flower Pot Man. Bill and Ben. Flower Pot Man. Then they're playing in the garden with their friends all day long.
It was a lovely hot summer's day in the garden, and Bill and Ben had found a new toy to play with.
Flubber!
Flubber lovely! Flubber lubber lava go!
Yeah!
Flubber!
Oh! Flubber bee! Flubber bee!
Flubber-do-do-do.
Oh! Hello, Bill. Ben, what are you up to?
A flubber-dubber-decret.
Oh, dear. Their secrets have a habit of turning into trouble.
So you see, my dears, we roses have a reputation to live up to. We are here to look beautiful, and we must at all times be dignified, on our best behavior, and... What was that?
Wasn't me.
Stop that! Stop it at once!
But it wasn't me!
So who was it? Oh, this is an outrage! We are supposed to be roses, not trombones!
Oh, slobber-dob.
Slobber-dob!
Oh, the roses are blooming in Piccadilly.
Ah! What's that? Help! What? If this has anything to do with those two hooligans, I'll... Give it here. Come on.
Hello, what's going on? Help! Hang on, who put the lights out? Is it night time? What's going on?
Ah, wait. I think it's about time you had a bit of a talk with those two.
Help!
One of these days, their mischief is going to get them into serious trouble. Now that their new toy had been taken away, Bill and Ben wondered what they could do next. They didn't have to wonder for long.
Did Flubber do?
Oh, Flub? Flubber do?
Flub?
Oh, Flubber there!
Hey, Flubber Nubber Netchup!
Flubber!
You're right. It is hot. And the man from the house hasn't been to water me for ages.
Flubber Nubber Dead of Water.
Oh, yes, Bill. We tomatoes need water. It's what makes us so big and round and red and juicy. And if we don't get water... Oh, dear.
Flubber, don't worry.
Thanks, you two. But hurry before it's... before it's too late. Oh, dear.
And a flubber keep.
Oh. Thank goodness. Water at last.
Flubberdoll.
Well, of course it's got a hole in it. It's a flare pot. Oh, well, thanks for trying anyway. It's been nice knowing you.
Bill had an idea. The two flowerpot men ran off, leaving Ketchup to wonder what it was.
You'll see, what they need is a few lessons in manners. Always gadding about without a bye or leave or how's your father. And now just hang on a minute there. If you think you're going to play more of your tricks with that hoe.
Whoa.
I thought I said no tricks. I'm all dizzy now.
It was a very good idea of Bill's. They were going to attach the hose to the tap, and then they could give Ketchup as much water as he liked. In the greenhouse, poor Ketchup was thirstier than ever.
Water! Oh, lovely, lovely water!
Flubber-da-da-ketchup!
Oh, yes! Much better, thanks. Oh, lovely. Oh, splash it all over.
Bill and Ben watered Ketchup until he wasn't thirsty anymore.
Oh, that's lovely, that is.
I think you did very well. Very well indeed.
Perhaps I've got the wrong day. Maybe he doesn't want to see me. Maybe...
Lindsay, is that you?
Yes. You haven't seen... Whoops, anywhere, have you?
Flob.
Flobby.
Oh, dear, oh, dear. See, he invited me round for tea, and he's not here. Maybe the crows have got him off. No.
What?
You don't think someone's taken him fishing?
No, I'm sure they haven't. He'll turn up. I expect he's just forgotten. Bill and Ben will help you look for him, won't you?
Bill and Ben hunted all over for Whoops, but finding a worm in a garden is not an easy thing to do.
Flub?
Oh, Flubber ain't here. In the barrel.
Flubber dubs.
Alas to something.
Flubber dubs.
Worms don't live in trees, birds do. And birds like worms.
Slowcoach, meanwhile, was not a happy tortoise. He'd been hearing voices.
Help!
Oh, there it is again.
Help!
Oh dear, if those two are playing tricks on me, I'll...
Slubber dubs!
Help!
Oh no, not more voices.
You two, eh?
Bill and Ben asked Slowcoach why he was hiding and why he was so far away from his home.
It's because ever since you spun me round on the end of that hose, I've been hearing voices. That's why.
Help!
Oh no, there it goes again.
Help! Help! Oh! Thank goodness. I thought I was stuck forever.
Flubber-dubber-dubber-da-da.
Well, I'm not entirely sure. It was earlier today. I was going about my business when suddenly I found myself in this long, dark tunnel. I shouted for help, but no one came. Then I heard you two Bob's your uncle. Here I am.
Well, it's good to have you back, Whoops.
And it's good to have you out of my shell. Worms.
Whoops, is it too late for tea?
Of course it isn't. And you can come too.
And so they did.
Bill and Ben, the flower pot men. Playing with their friends, now they'll be sleeping in their pots all night long. Bill and Ben, the flower pot. Bill and Ben. Bill and Ben. The Flower Pot Man. The Flower Pot Bill and Ben. The Flower Pot Man.
One morning, the garden was covered in snow and ice. Bill and Ben were looking forward to a wonderful winter's day.
Oh, be careful! It was cold last night, so the snow's become very icy. Don't try to run, just slide your feet one after the other. Well done! You're both skating!
Rubber day! Rubber rubber ballet!
Skating isn't easier. Not for me, it isn't. I don't know what skating is.
Rubber rubber slide a feet!
Oh, all right. I'll try. You can skate if you want. I'll stick to rolling.
Bill and Ben were thrilled they'd learned how to skate.
Hello.
Have you seen the snowballs?
Flubber-dubber-dubber.
The children are having a game. They've made balls of snow. I was almost hit.
Flubber-dubber-dubber.
Yes, Ben, that is a snowball.
Flubbing up. What was that?
Flubber-dubber-boo.
I should hope you are sorry, Bill. First skating, now snowballs. I hate winter. Flubber-doo.
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 Whoa.
Flubber-dubber-dome.
Bill and Ben were sorry they'd hit Garden Gnome, so they tried to teach him to make snowballs. Next door, Tad the Frog was showing off.
I'm not scared of a bit of cold water. I'll jump into that pond and have a swim.
Hey?
Dear me, Tad. You're not scared of a bit of cold water, are you?
There's a frog in that pond. It's staring at me. It'll jump at me next.
Frogs do things like that.
Flubber-doo-dubber-doo.
Bill and Ben invited Garden Gnome to join their game, but he didn't seem interested. He was made of concrete.
It's all right for you two having fun. You should see what's going on next door. There's another frog. It's moved into my pond and it's sitting there staring at me.
Rubber frog.
Bill and Ben. Let's hope they chase the new frog away. We don't want two frogs in our garden, darling buds, do we?
No. I don't see why not.
Right. Let's see if he's still there.
Yes! Look!
Flubber-den.
You're right. Two more flower pot men.
Bill, Ben and Tad didn't know the ice on the pond was like a mirror. They were looking at reflections of themselves.
Rubber, fling them away.
Ben wanted to chase the new flower pot men away. But Bill thought they might be friendly.
Flubbered end.
You're right, Bill. Those flower pot men won't want to stay in cold water. Right, find something to pull them out with and I'll keep an eye on them.
Oh.
Hey? Oh, they've gone. But how?
In the shed, the man who works in the garden had been painting the frame of an old mirror.
Ooh, flubbered up.
Oh, hey, rubber lab.
How had the other flower pot men got to the shed so quickly?
Ooh. Hey, rubber flared.
They wouldn't say. Ben wanted to know their names.
Flubber-dubber-dubber-dubber.
Perhaps they weren't called anything at all, so Bill and Ben gave them names.
Flubber-Bob.
Now, one was called Bert, and one was called Bob.
Flubber-dubber-dubber-dubbert. Flubber-hello.
Bill and Ben had to leave Bert and Bob while they washed the paint from Ben's hands.
It's a flubber-dubber-dubber-bob.
I say, who are you talking to in that bucket?
Flubber-lubber-flubber, then.
I never knew there were other flower pot men.
Shh. Bert, hello.
Bert and Bob, huh?
Flubber-dubber-bird.
Yes. If I see Bert and Bob planning any more tricks, I'll let you know.
Ooh. Rub-a-dub-a-dub.
Bill wanted to play a trick on Bert and Bob. He and Ben would creep so quietly back to Tad's pond that Bert and Bob wouldn't even know they'd gone.
In all my years, I've never heard of any other flower pot men.
Shh! Here they come now.
They look like Bill and Ben.
Well, Bert and Bob look like Bill and Ben. So that proves it was Bert and Bob. I'll follow them.
No, I haven't seen this Bert or this Bob of yours. They must still be in that bucket. But the other frog's in the pond. Look! Flubber-lubber-Bob!
Flubber-lubber-Bert?
Yes! How did Bert and Bob get back here without us seeing them?
Aha! Caught you at last. You've been playing tricks on Bill and Ben.
No, this is Bill and Ben.
No, it's Bert and Bob.
No, Bert and Bob are in the pond.
They can't be. Let me look. Oh no, another squirrel. I must hide my nuts.
What is she talking about?
I've an idea. Why don't you play a game? Bert and Bob and the other frog will want to join in.
Snowballs! Everyone likes playing snowballs. They're not joining in.
Now the ice was cracked and covered in snowballs, Bill, Ben and Tad couldn't see reflections of themselves.
The new flower pot men have gone. And the other frog.
I expect they think snowball games are too rough. They've probably gone back to their own gardens.
Flub.
Yeah, but it's strange we didn't see them go.
Hello, Bill. Hello, Ben. Where are you, Bert and Bob?
Bill and Ben told Weed that Bert and Bob had gone home. But thanks to Weed, they'd learned to skate. So in the end, it had been a wonderful winter's day.